For this example, we have f of x equals the product of square root x plus x to the negative first and x squared plus 1. So for our convenience, I'm going to rename f of x as the function y and then treat it as the product of the function f and the function g. Set on the side, the function f for our case is square root x plus x to the negative first. Function g is x squared plus 1. Recall we have the power rule. So whatever we have as a radical, we're going to change into the power. And square root x is the same as x to the power 1/2. And then we can go ahead and find the derivative of the f using the power rule. The first term will get 1/2 x to the power negative 1/2. Second term will be negative 1 x to the power negative 2nd. And then for the g prime, the derivative gonna be 2x plus 0 or just 2x. Now we get all the prep work that we have done. Next, back to the problem. Our goal is to find y prime. Y prime using the product rule gonna be the product of the f and g prime added by the product of the f prime and the g, or mix and match group. Then replace the f with the quantity square root x, or we can write as x to the power 1/2 plus x to the negative first, and multiply by g prime, which is 2x, plus the f prime, or 1/2 multiplied by x to the negative 1/2 minus x to the power negative 2nd, and multiply by g, which is x squared plus 1. We are done applying the formula. Next, we're gonna simplify. So this step is apply step. And next step gonna be simplify. To simplify, you're gonna use the property of the exponents. Like when you multiply or distribute, use the distributive property. And then we're gonna consider the power by adding the power if you multiply with the same base. So for the y prime, after you multiply 2x, to x to the 1/2, gonna be 2 times x to the, recall 2x is 2x to the first power. So when you multiply, the power gonna be added together, so which is 1/2 plus 1. And then the next gonna be 2 times x to the first times x to the negative first. And then similar way for the second product here, x squared multiplied by 1/2, x to the negative 1/2. I'm going to write step by step just to minimize the confusion that you might have. And then plus 1 over 2 x to the negative 1/2 minus x to the negative 2nd. And then we're going to clean up. We're going to simplify. Recall when you add the power, the fraction here, the first term becomes 2 times x to the power 3 over 2. Second term gonna be 2 times x to the power 0. The next term is 1/2 x to the power 3 over 2 and minus x to the power 0. Next term is 1/2 x to the negative 1/2 and the last is negative x to the negative 2nd. And next step, we're gonna collect the like terms. For the first group of the like terms, we look at the term or the coefficient of x to the power 3/2. So right now we have 2 plus 1/2, which is 5 over 2 of the variable x raised to the power 3/2. And next one, the x to the power 0, which is 1. Basically 2 times x to the power 0 is just 2. And x to the power 0 is 1. So we have plus 2 minus 1. Plus 2 and minus 1, and it will return plus 1 for the power 0 group. And the last two terms, they are no like terms, so we just carry whatever it is. So 1/2, this is plus I, x to the power 1/2, and then minus x to the power negative 2nd. It looks like we have the fraction power and the negative power and so forth. To make it look prettier, so we can do one more step as a simplified step. So So this one, it can be done by rewriting the negative power as a positive power. I'm going to write a note over here. This is the same as 1 over x to the power 1 half. And x to the power 1 half is square root x. For this term, this is the same as 1 over x to the second. So if Hawk's Learning asks you to write the answer in the positive power form, here is the final answer. I'm going to write in different colors, so we'll make it distinguish. So equals 5 over 2 times x to the power 3 over 2 plus 1 plus 1 over 2 times square root x, and then minus 1 over x to the second as the derivative of the function in this problem.